Hello students, today I am going to explain degree and cardinality. So a relationship type and relationship set. A relationship type represents the association between entity types. For example, enrolled in is a relationship type that exists between entity types student and course. In ER diagram, relationship type is represented by a diamond and connecting the entities with lines. यहाँ पर हम आसानी से ये देख सकते हैं कि यहाँ पर दो entities हैं, एक student है और एक entity course है, और दोनों ही entity enrolled in relationship के through attached हैं. इसको हम diamond जो relationship है, इसको हम diamond box के through represent करते हैं और entities को कनेक्ट करने के लिए स्ट्रेट लाइन के थ्रू हम रिप्रेजेंट करते हैं. दिस इज अ रिलेशनशिप एंड दिस इज अ एंटिटी टाइप. अ सेट ऑफ रिलेशनशिप्स ऑफ सेम टाइप इज नोन एज रिलेशनशिप सेट. द फॉलोइंग रिलेशनशिप एज डिपिक्ट्स S1 इज एनरोल्ड इन C2 एंड S2 इज एनरोल्ड इन C1 एंड S3 इज एनरोल्ड इन C3. हियर यू कैन इजीली सी द एंटिटी S1. And there is a relationship set that is E1, E2, E3, and there is an entity type C1, C2, and C3. The S1 is related to the C2, and S2 is related to the C1, and S3 is related to the C3 with the relation E1, E2, and E3. Now, the degree of a relationship set. The number of different entity sets participating in a relationship set is called as degree of a relationship set. इसका मतलब ये है कि कितनी entities participate कर रही हैं relationship में, उसको हम उसकी degree कहते हैं. For example, और ये तीन तरीके की होती हैं. Number one is unary relationship. When there is only one entity set participating in a relation, the relationship is called as unary relationship. For example, one person is married to only one person. इस example में आप देख रहे हैं, there is in one entity person is related to married to relationship. एक person जो है वो एक ही person से marry करेगा. यहाँ पर ये relationship depict कर रहा है, there is only one entity is related to one relationship. That's why इसकी degree जो होगी वो one होगी. Now another one is binary relationship. When there are two entity set participating in a relation, the relationship is called as binary relationship. For example, the student is enrolled in a course. यहाँ पर आप देख सकते हैं कि student और course दो entities हैं और वो एक relationship enrolled in के through connected हैं. इसलिए इसकी जो degree होगी वो बाइनरी होगी, यानी कि दो होगी. स्टूडेंट एंड कोर्स आर द टू एंटिटीज रिलेटेड विद एनरोल्ड इन रिलेशनशिप. नंबर थ्री इज एन अरे रिलेशनशिप. व्हेन देयर आर एन एंटिटीज सेट पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन अ रिलेशन, द रिलेशनशिप इज कॉल्ड एज एन अरे रिलेशनशिप. मोर देन टू एंटिटीज कैन रिलेट इन अ रिलेशनशिप, देन इट इज नोन एज an array relationship. Now the cardinality. The number of times an entity set participates in a relation set is known as cardinality. इसका मतलब ये है कि किसी भी relationship में entities कितने बार participate कर रही है, उसको हम बोलते हैं participate in a relationship is known as its cardinality. Cardinality can be of different types. Number one is one-to-one cardinality. When each entity in each entity set can take part only once in the relationship, the cardinality is one-to-one. Let us assume that a male can marry to one female and a female can marry to one male. So the relationship will be one-to-one. In this example, you can easily see the relationship between one entity to one entity is one-to-one, because one entity related to another entity by one means मेल जो है वो मैरी करेगा केवल एक फीमेल से, और एक फीमेल जो है वो मैरी करेगी एक मेल से. in the sets you can use, you can easily see M1 is related to F2, M2 is related to F1, and M3 is related to F3. And it is one male is related to one female only. That's why it is one-to-one relationship. Many-to-one relationship. Many-to-one relationship is when entities in one entity set can take part only once in the relationship set, and entities in another entity set can take part more than once in the relationship set. Cardinality is many-to-one. Let us assume that a student can take only one course, but one course can be taken by many students. Here you can easily see the n student can enroll in a one course. For example, if there is a course of MCA or whatever the course is, the number of n students can be participated in a single course. That is known as many to one course. You can easily see with the using the set representation, the S2, S3, S4 are related with the C3. C3 is a course, so you can easily see the more than one student can participate in a C3, any C3 course. So here the cardinality is many to one. Many to many, when entities in all entity set can take part more than once in the relationship, cardinality is many to many. Let us assume that a student can take more than one course, and one course can be taken by many students, so the relationship will be many to many. Here you can see easily m students can take part in a registered or enrolled in a one course, and one course can be taken by more than one students. Yet you can easily see the S1 can be taken by the opted C1 and C3. यानी कि S1 जो है वो दो courses को opt कर रहा है, more than one course को opt कर रहा है, और जो C3 course है, इस ये जो है एक से ज़्यादा students के through opt किया जा रहा है, यानी S1, S3 and S4 can be taken by the are taking the course C3. C3 can be taken by the S1, S3 and S4, and S2 can be taken by the C1 and C3. Hence the cardinality is many to many. Thank you.